Quixel Mixer is fairly new to the 3D texture painting market, but it's free and it's already shaping up to be a great alternative to a Substance Painter, at least in the future. But one thing you'll be confronted with right at the start is that there are very few brush presets available. These two at the bottom are already custom ones that I made. These are all that are available from the start. Thankfully, it's quite easy to create your own. Of course, there is the online library, where you also have a lot of brushes, but all of these cost credits that you will get when you subscribe to the Megascans library, but if you just want to use it as a free alternative, then you probably don't want to pay for all of these brushes. Thankfully, it's easy to create your own ones, and I'm going to show you how. First of all, you will need any kind of painting or photo manipulation software. I'm going to use Affinity Photo, but you can use Adobe Photoshop, you can use GIMP, and honestly, you could even use Microsoft Paint. I'm here in Affinity Photo, and I'm going to create a new document, and it's important that the aspect ratio is 1:1. I'm going to use 800x800. That's probably a very high resolution for a brush, but so far it worked out pretty good for me, without huge performance issues, while at the same time having a very large resolution to really scale up my brush. First, we will create a new solid layer, and this layer has to be black, as the brushes in Quixel Mixer work on grayscale images. So now I will create a new layer, and here we will actually create the pattern of our brush. As we only have very few basic brushes in Quixel Mixer right now, I'm going to create a new textured brush. I'm going to click on my brush, change my color to white, select the brushes, I'm going to go to textures, going to select a good brush pattern that I think I'll need, like this one, and now I'm going to increase the size. There we go, and now I'm just going to click once, no, maybe twice, and there we go, this can already be our brush. I'm going to hit on File and Export, and I'm going to choose JPEG because in my experience Quixel Mixer struggled a little bit with the PNGs. And I'm just going to save my brush. And now we're back in Quixel Mixer. If you don't have your brush settings open, you have to create a new paint layer. And then under Brush Shape, you will click on this little rectangle here to load your image, and simply load in the cracks or your brush that you've created before. And there we go, we can already start painting with our brush. As you can see, now we have some great cracks, and we can increase the angle jitter so we can really create some cracked surfaces. If you know you're only going to use this brush for this one project, you probably don't want to save this. But if you know this is going to be a brush that you are going to use on several projects, then you can go up here and hit Save Brush. Give it a name. And now if we look up here, we can see that our brush was saved. Unfortunately, the icon is pretty dim. Actually, we don't see anything. This is because our actual brush here in Affinity Photo doesn't really have much brightness and contrast. We can fix that by increasing the contrast. And now we can export it again. And we can reload our cracks. And well, still not really visible, but it's better. Save it again, replace it. And generally, it's a good idea to increase the contrast because you can always decrease the opacity in Quixel Mixer, but it's difficult to get these really sharp cracks if your image is very dim from the start. And remember that you can use all kinds of things for your brushes, text, shapes, or the brushes that you have in your painting application. And since it's only black and white images, you can fairly easily create them and import them into Quixel Mixer. you can head over to my website with a pack of 10 free brushes that I would recommend you have when you're starting in Quixel Mixer. I hope you learned something, and see you later.